subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson.
Welcome to another class. So in this class we are going to study about bar body and dosage compensation. So what is meant by bar body? So we all know that males possess X and Y chromosomes and females have two X chromosomes as sex chromosomes. When compare male and female, males have only one X chromosome and females have two X chromosomes. One of the X chromosomes in female is inactivated randomly during the early embryonic development by a process known as heterochromatinization. So the inactivated X chromosome appears as a darkly stained structure near the nuclear membrane. So this is the nucleus and this is the nuclear membrane. So the pink colored one here is known as a bar body. So this bar body is first described by scientist Murray L. Barr while he conducting experiments on the chromatin bodies in female calico cat's nerve cell. So this cat has a different fur colors. So it contains blotches of black and orange color fur on the body. So for that he conducted experiments and he find out that it is due to the inactivation of one of the X chromosomes in the females, and he called that inactivated X chromosome as a bar body. So the bar body is present near to the, so this is the nucleus, so this is the nuclear membrane, close to the nuclear membrane. So in human beings, human females also, bar body can be demonstrated in the buccal mucosa cells and fibroblast cells, and it appears as a drumstick in neutrophil cells. So we can easily calculate the number of bar bodies in an individual. So which using a simple formula, number of bar bodies equal to n minus 1, where n is equal to number of X chromosomes. We observe this table, the female, normal female contains 46 chromosomes and 2 X chromosomes are present. So when we calculate the number of bar bodies, 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Likewise, Turner's female contains 45 chromosomes. The females contains only 1 X chromosome. So the number of bar bodies is 0. 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Klinefelter's males contains 47 chromosomes in which XXY, 2 X chromosomes and 1 Y chromosome are present. So number of X chromosomes equal to 2. So the bar bodies is 1. Pauli females which contain 4 X chromosomes, number of bar bodies is equal to 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So like this we can calculate the number of bar bodies depending upon the number of chromosomes. So we all know that males contains 1 X chromosome and 1 Y chromosome and females contains 2 X chromosomes. So males have only 1 X chromosome and females have 2 X chromosomes. So the copies of genes which are present on the X chromosome is only single in males and copy of genes in females are 2 in number. To make it equal in both the sexes, the copies of genes which are present on the X chromosomes of male and female, to make it equal in both the sexes, inactivation of one of the X chromosomes occurs in female. So that process is known as lineization, and this lineization helps the dosage compensation. So the dosage compensation is nothing but to equalize the expression of genes present on the X chromosome in both sexes, male and female. So both male and female contains only one functional copy of genes on the X chromosomes. So the inactivation of the other X chromosome in females is done by lineization. So lineization is nothing but it makes X chromosome transcriptionally inactive during the early embryonic development. So
A long RNA wound around the one of the X chromosomes and it tightly wound to the X chromosome and it does not allow it to transcribe. So like that it makes it inactive during the embryonic development itself, either during blastocyst stage or onset of the gastrulation stage. Which chromosome, which X chromosome? So the females get one X chromosome from mother and from one X chromosome from father. So maternal X chromosome is inactivated in some cells and paternal X chromosome is inactivated in some other cells. So the descendants of these cells have the inactive X chromosome throughout their life. But it is reversed in germ cells. So the inactivation is reversed in germ cells so that inactivation does not pass on to the gamete cells. That's why the gamete cells contain two X functional X chromosomes. So that is the difference between the somatic cells and the germ cells. In germ cells, two X chromosomes are active, but in somatic cells, one of the X chromosome is inactivated during the early development to compensate for dosage compensation. So this dosage compensation is first described by Mary Leon. That's why the inactivation is known as lionization. I hope you understand. Happy studying.